Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Two Bros Game Night. I am your host, Older Bro.
I'm your other host, Younger Bro.
And today we continue in Michael Jackson Moratorium 2021.
Yeah, the rest of the songs are, by my opinion, some of these songs I don't even know if I ever played more than once. Like this song, I know for a fact I never did. I know this song, but.
It's a soul song. I don't know if it's Christian specifically, but it's soul. Then again, it starts off by talking about the River Jordan, so yes. Says you, the person who's like, oh, I'm doing all these video games, but I really like to do this music stuff and video and all this, you know, these, you know, I want to write a story for a game and stuff like that. And it's just like, one day, there may be a person watching what you've done saying, dude, why the fuck didn't you stick with what you were good at? Like, stop making all this shitty music and just keep playing video games, you fucking asshole. But as I'm saying, like, you've talked about, like, how you want to do, like, you know, a sing thing, where it's, like, where we do some songs, and it's, like, where we do covers of songs. It's, like, there may be a kid in 120 years who looks back on those songs and says, why the fuck did Two Bros Game Night do those songs when Younger Bro's clearly not that good at it? Why don't you just stick to video games and, you know, writing shitty romance games or something? Like, I don't know, why didn't he stick to that? Why would he ever do this? You never know in the future when someone will look at your work and just say, oh, this was the shit they used to do. Oh god, get rid of that. We do the shit to ourselves.
Like, we do look back on, like, some of our older videos.
Well, to be fair, we look back at some of our older videos and we're like, we didn't have the experience or the software to make these better. And they're still not that great, but at least they're better now. Yeah. Well, this series is a separate thing. Yeah, this is... Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, he has been risen to parts unknown. Are you wanting me to decide if he's in heaven or hell right now? Because I don't think I feel comfortable with that. Like,
where the hell is Michael back? Well, he's 6 feet down.
Six feet under, down. Slowly. Slowly decomposing. Nope.
I think I did last two. I don't think I did last two.
Okay. Damn loading screen! Earth, wind, and fire?
This, by my opinion, is probably the lamest song.
Lamest song.
I actually hate this song. Like, visual design, just, no, I don't like it. Because to me, it's like...
What about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were...
like the other parts of the song sound like him, and then when he gets here, it's like, what's going
on? Yeah.
Like, I like these parts of this song, but I don't like.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sorry if this is like your favorite NBA song.
How dare you?
How dare you? You have a good message. I mean, yeah, the message is not good, but like,
yeah. Yeah.
Like, I appreciate the message. I appreciate this. I appreciate some of the time.
This sounds like a very instrumental song, and you're not a big fan of instrumentals. Like, if just like.
When he goes, ooh, I think, ooh, don't, baby, please don't go.
Yeah.
Like, it sounds like that. I mean, there are some.
Again, I'm still thinking of Earth, Wind, and Fire.
Earth, Wind, and Fire probably have a better Earth song than Funky.
Well, they have. Yeah, pretty sure they do. Now all I can think about what about us is what about us? What about all? The pink song, I think it is. What about us?
Yeah, I like how I got oh, I get it that time.
Uh-huh. Torn apart by Creed. Wait a minute. Wait, you cannot just pull Apollo Creed into your song for no, with no context.
You see, he wanted to be in that movie, but they he was mad that they were.
Well, I think they're meaning the person Apollo Creed that's is based on. But okay, whatever.
I think he was.
I don't know.
They
got James Brown. Yeah, seriously. Yeah. I mean, to be fair, Apollo Creed is in. One. Yeah, he's in those movies, so he probably is just referring to him.
I actually. For my second time ever playing that song, I actually think it was cool. I don't want to.
I'm trying to find out.
I like Don't Care About Us, but it's definitely better than Earth Song.
I'm trying to find if Creed is actually based on a real person.
Oh, it's like we're in jail.
I don't think he is, actually. Disappointing.
Wait, Apollo Creed?
There he is. He's vaguely based on Muhammad Ali.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, and a few other people. Inspired by the real life champion Muhammad Ali. Yeah, there you go. Micah, you can't say everyone's gone bad just because you wrote the song bad. It's a, yeah, well, this is more a manifesto. This is more just like, they don't give a shit about you. Fuck, yeah, fuck them all. Stop referencing yourself.
They care if you're fucking.
I swear if he says I'm a smooth criminal, I'd fuck it. I'm bad. I'm a smooth criminal.
How bad I am.
I have a wife and two children. Well, now it's three. To be fair, this song is literally supposed to be about him. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is supposed to be a lot about him, though. About, like, his, like, all the stuff going on, people suing him, and, like, all, you know, all the claims against him. So, to be fair, he has a bit of a reason to be a bit pissed off, but, like, the song where he's the most pissed off is one of his, like, not calmest songs, but it's, like, it's not as in-your-face. You'd assume that a song about him being pissed off... Yeah, you'd assume that a song about him being pissed off about all the, you know, problems with, like, the public and the police and, you know, the system, like, all this shit. Roosevelt was living. He wouldn't let this be. Holy shit. Teddy Roosevelt's gonna come down and bitch slap all you for this shit. Like, I guess he could have been talking about FDR, but no, he was talking about Teddy Roosevelt. Fuck.
He's
a rough rider. Come beat the shit out of you. I don't think he was in a Western, but he definitely was filmed. Like, he was definitely people. He was a, like, folk hero, basically. But. Yeah, you know what? But, yeah. I don't know. This song is pretty decent, but it's just like, it just feels a lot more, if Martin Luther was living, no one would care about him because he's not Martin Luther King. You're talking about Martin Luther King. Martin Luther just fucking put a damn piece of paper on the Catholic Church's door and was like, fuck you all. You're talking about King. I hate how many people do that. When they're talking about MLK, they talk about Martin Luther. It's like, no! First off, Martin Luther King had a son named Junior, and we have to talk about him and put the Junior in. But you also can't just say Martin Luther because that's the Protestant Reformation guy! Like, my god, you have to be more specific than this, people. By the way, guys, we did confirm off camera, Younger Bro actually didn't know the song that we talked about last episode. I don't know how that's possible. I've literally played it for him multiple times. I guarantee I have. I've played my whole damn jazz playlist for you before, and that song has been in there for many, many, many years since I started that playlist. I have no clue how it's possible you couldn't know that. Yeah, that's fine. But I'm just like, there's no way I haven't played that for you. You must have just completely ignored it, but... That's beside the point. Yeah. No, I'm pretty sure it's just ghosts.
My cousin's second favorite.
Yeah.
Yeah. For a time it was a favorite, and then he... This is a better song than Speed Demon.
Having somebody say Speed Demon is Michael Jackson's best song is like the most heretical thing in the universe. when Thriller exists, when Bad exists, when Smooth Criminal exists.
I love
like,
Mike
are
Dust.
You serious?
Yeah,
who
Mike
thinks
Dust
Speed Demon is his best song?
Yeah, I love Mike Dust, but it's just like, no, you're wrong.
You're just wrong.
Yeah, I remember that.
Okay. I'm gonna look up Speed Demon, okay? Speed Demon comics. Oh, that's what he's talking about. It's the fictional Marvel character, Speed Demon. Clearly. Oh, I love when you go onto a page and it says, for the DC Comics version, see Speed Demon DC Comics. So great, there's a Speed Demon in both Marvel and DC.
Oh, wow. Which one did
we
use?
Trying to find the... There it is. I was trying to find the Wikipedia page for the song. Received mixed reviews. Who the hell would have guessed? According to this, Jackson wrote the song after he received a traffic ticket. Which, no, Speed Demon. That song's about him getting a traffic ticket and arriving late to the recording studio.
That is funny.
He didn't even report it at any of his world tours or any of his tours at all. So he doesn't even like he never even like performed it. Critical reception, mixed. It's filler. Utterly faceless, lacking memorable hooks and melodies. Holy shit. Churning along relentlessly. What? According to this, somebody tried to say that it was a fun funk rock song that had sit happily on a Prince album. Bullshit. Fuck off. If you think Prince would sing Speed Demon, you're fucking insane.
Yeah, also they did this on stage where he...
Yeah. To be fair, though, the guy from AllMusic who did that quote about it being a sequence that's utterly faceless, lacking memorable hooks and melodies, he was talking about both Speed Demon and Another Part of Me. Which I don't think is a opinion that helps. Because Another Part of Me is like pretty light. It's just another part of me. But yeah, it seems like it was doesn't seem like it was very well.
I'd imagine not.
It's not. Yeah, it's not telling me how bad it was received though. Let's just flip to all music. Go to the site, you ink dinguses. Speed Demon. Michael Jackson. User rating 3 of 5 stars. So 60%.
I have 4 stars for that.
Not bad. Not bad. There's also, by the way, a remix by Nero. Yes.
What?
Which I kind of want to listen to. I kind of want to listen to that. Not right now, but
yeah, just what the hell is it up?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look that up and see what Nero did to it. They might have made it good.
Not Nero!
Okay, this song, I don't know if I ever played.
Yeah.
So, I don't know how good this is. It's what funny.
I just want to make the world change. This one sounds unique enough. Oh boy! Okay, so.
He must have watched James Bond and
so, yeah, this is corporate espionage, murder.
Die for it, I don't know about that.
Well, fuck trusts. Wow, he got. What trust pissed you off today, Michael? What the fuck?
This is weird.
Remember when I said the previous one was a manifesto? You know what? I think this one's also a manifesto. Just... all they give a shit about is the money. Fuck, you know, they don't give a shit about you or anything else. Let's be honest, a lot of companies, I'm pretty sure the devil just works there part-time. Hey look, the devil is a part-timer!
Even Michael Jackson said it here.
Sue her for the money.
Holy
fuck. Whoa. What's the story of this? Hold on. What? Let me look up the story of this song. What the fuck? It's lyrically interesting. Is the song just called Money?
Yeah, it's just Money.
What in the fuck is this song about? From his Paranoia album, of course it is. Let me look up meaning. Wow. Okay, we were not fucking joking here. So, the seventh track on this album, Money was written and produced entirely by Michael Jackson. In Money, he whispers, "You'll do anything for the money." Apparently directed at the father of the boy. Remember I talked about the three people who were currently suing Michael Jackson, and one of them was the father of a kid who refused to testify against Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
That's this guy. It was directed at the father of the boy who made the 1993 molestation charges and to whom Jackson paid a multi-million dollar settlement. The boy later admitted to lying for the money. It's literally him pissed off about that fucking kid and his father who sued him and lied to earn money. And then other people keep putting stuff in here about the Illuminati.
I kind of believe that.
Holy shit, yeah. Yeah. That's fucking hell. Let me see. Let me go to a different site and see what they say. We'll do our due diligence. These are just the lyrics, not the meaning.
You know what, Michael? For all you know, you predicted this hit. They might have told you to the devil. Oh,
yeah, let's look off genius.com and see what they say. Song, like much of the album, deals with Michael Jackson's paranoia about his so-called friends who are just out to exploit him for the money he earns. Written and composed not long after the child sex abuse allegations. Yeah. That's a pretty, I think that story's, yeah, that, meaning is pretty, accurate. Just, they are out to steal my money and just abuse and lie about me to get it. Fucking hell.
I love this.
Now this is a different sound.
Yeah, this one's more fun. Oh, wait, yes. No, this is I Wanna Rock. Wait, is it? I Wanna Rock with You and Four Spots Master Player.
This might be able to go on a Prince soundtrack.
Now, this one's
Yeah. Yeah, this one's definitely one of the ones that is unique.
Yeah, this is definitely.
Yeah, this is also gonna be the last song for this video.
Yeah.
Sorry, you can't use the word force now, that word's copyrighted by Disney. I should make that argument by friends. That anytime it says force damage, it's all the force. Aw, that'd be so great. Yeah. When Michael Jackson's having fun, he does very good music. When he's pissed off, his songs are okay. And when he's trying to be, like, heartfelt and soulful, it's just like, no, stop. Stop asking people to touch you, Michael Jackson. I'm just telling you for the future.
Well, unfortunately, if he heard you, then, wouldn't it be funny?
That's not necessarily a bad thing. It's a good song, but it's just like, I think Michael Jackson having to deal with all the shit, probably isn't, worth that one song. Yeah, seriously. Boogie Fever!
This is absolutely disco.
Oh yeah. Disco never really died. Like, people think that, like, oh, after, you know, after the burnings and stuff, disco just died off. And it's like, no! Disco just kind of was still there,
It's still there in the background.
Yeah, it was in the background. It was much smaller, but disco didn't die, and it just became soul and funk and stuff like that. Like, it changed with the times. But you still get disco-sounding songs, still. Especially from Bruno Mars. Whenever I listen to Bruno Mars, I always get that feeling that he really wants to be Prince or Michael Jackson. He really wants to be about 20, like, he really wants to be alive about 20, 30 years ago, making the same music he's making now, and being, like, a global superstar. But he's like 20 years late, and he's just like, But I've still got these good songs in me. I'm still making them. And he's right. It's still good music. No one hates on Michael Jackson, or on, not Michael Jackson, on Bruno Mars for his songs.
Yeah.
Because who's he working with right now? I think it's Daft Punk, maybe, or somebody else. He's working with somebody where he has, like, a duo band that's making that music, Ian. Yeah. Yeah, I just don't remember who it is. Probably not Daft Punk. I just don't remember who it was.
Hey, guys, we only got 3 songs left, so yep. That's the episode's finale. Hey,
yep.
Look, rock with you.
There you go. Alright, guys, that's gonna be it for this episode. We will come back next time and continue on and hopefully finish up, unless something fucking weird
it's
goes on.
Shouldn't be.
So anyways, that's gonna be it for this episode. We're gonna come back next time. Continue on in this game. Until then, the future's very uncertain. What is certain is you guys are awesome, and there'll be more Two Bros Game Night tomorrow. See you then.
Goodbye.